Good day, viewers. I am Abraham Daniel Yakubu, the team facilitator of Legu Aid of the Assured Future Empowerment Initiative. You know, we are here to enlighten you on your rights, your fundamental rights, and to help you with your legal issues, legal questions you might have. Today we'll be talking about the fundamental rights available in Nigeria. You know, the Nigerian Constitution in Chapter 4 expressly states some fundamental rights available to its citizens. You know, Chapter 4 covers from Section 33 to 46. We have the right to life, right to dignity of a person, right to personal liberty, right to fair hearing, right to private and family life, and so on. Why do we need those rights? You know, as citizens, we've submitted all the power to the government. Now, the government gave us those rights to enjoy, and no constitution will stand without providing for the right for its citizens. Because when there is law, it should be right that people will enjoy under this law. If not so, we won't have a society where people can live. Let's talk about the right to life. Section 33 of the 1999 Constitution of Nigeria has amended, actually stated that everyone has a right to life. Everyone has the right to be. You can't just take the life of any other person without a just cause. Although the exception, but as a human being, the law is there to protect you. Not even the law enforcement agent will just come and take your life. No. The law is there to protect the life of every person, every citizen. If you don't have this right, you know the life. That means the life is not living, but this world is not living for you. That is why the Constitution provides for it, and it has been guaranteed by the Section 33 of the 1999 Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. As I said, mentioned earlier, the exception to which, when there is a court order, because in Nigeria we still have what we call offenses that carry capital punishment. There are some, like murder, armed robbery, they carry capital punishment, which is death penalty. Maybe when the police, the law enforcement agencies are trying to effect an arrest and the person is using force, the law also permits them to use reasonable force to apprehend such a person. Sometimes such force may lead to the death of the person they sought to arrest. So if it is done in the normal way, then this are counted as part of the exception to right to life. But aside that, no person has the right to take their life of another person. Okay, in defense of someone's self, somebody want to attack me, yeah, I have the right to defend myself against such a person. Maybe in the process, I kill the person. This is part of the exceptions. But as every person, aside from these, every person, every citizen has the right to life. Then we also have what we call the right to the dignity of the human person. No human is to be subjected to torture. No person is subjected to slavery. Every man is born to be free. Then we also have these rights to personal liberty, as right to fair hearing. Right to fair hearing, section 46 is telling us that's come. When there is a case against anyone, in court, civil, criminal, a person should be heard. The person should be allowed to defend himself, either personally or through a legal practitioner. As a matter of fact, in Section 36 of 5 says, of the 1999 Constitution of Nigeria, says, everyone charged with a criminal offense is presumed to be innocent until the contrary has been proved. That is fair hearing. The other person must be allowed to talk. Come and defend yourself. You that is alleging that this person has committed a crime, come and prove it beyond reasonable doubt. Then the court says, okay, truly, he has done what you accuse him of, then sentence him given the normal punishment. You as a private individual, any government agency, aside the court, no one has the power. No one, I repeat again, no one has